Do you need to get a book, an ebook, or a physical book to supplement the training in a typical programming video course? Let's talk about that in today's video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And the question was whether you need a book to supplement the training in a typical video programming course. In general, my answer would be no. Certainly that's the case in my courses because I've designed my courses to be really complete in the sense that they teach you virtually everything you need to know about a particular topic. And if you go and grab a book, which is probably a natural human thing to do, to be looking at something to supplement, and that can certainly be something you need to do if you're taking a college or university course. But with a video programming course, that can even be self-defeating. So you can find that you'll be learning a lot in a programming video course. If you go off and get an ebook or a physical book, you might find that you almost certainly will find that the style being taught in that book is different to the video course and can actually introduce some confusion. So in general, I would say no. But the other thing to keep in mind here, and perhaps the more important reason, is that physical books and ebooks often are out of date. They don't get updated for whatever reason anywhere near as much as a video programming course is. So you might be looking for a book to supplement your training and you find a great one. And if you haven't really thoroughly investigated it, you might find that it's 5 or 10 years old. Now, to give you an example of that, there was a book that I used to recommend, a great book on Java programming. And back in the day, I used to recommend that to my team, because I was a project lead for various projects. When a junior programmer came along, I would actually physically buy them a copy of the book or recommend that they buy it. And that was great because it was up to date. The name of the book, the author was Bruce Eckel, and it was a fantastic book. And I'll put a link up, put a link in the video, not for you to buy it because I don't recommend you buy it, but just so you can see which book that I was talking about. The reason that book was great was because it was up to date and very relevant at the time. But 10 years or so have passed now, and that book hasn't really been updated. So if you were to go and buy that book now and start reading it, not only will it not take advantage of all the modern features of, in this case, Java, but you might find that there's now better, almost certainly there's better ways of doing things than was taught in that programming book. And that's fine, that's understandable because it's now 10 years out of date. So the point that I'm trying to make here is if you're looking for a book, it can be self-defeating unless you can find one that's particularly up-to-date in your quest to become a programmer. So I would stick to a video course, finish the video course, and look, perhaps after the video course, once you're done with that, then start looking. But if you are really persistent and you really want to grab a book, be sure to check the publication date, check if it's been updated, make sure that it's fairly relevant, make sure that if it's a programming language book, that it's targeting the latest release of the software, the programming language. It's very important to make sure that it does that. But lastly, also check the reviews. Very important to check how other people, other buyers of that book, have they actually found the book? Has it been rewarding for them? What are the good things about the book? What are the bad things? Reviews are very important, actually, in both books, but also in video courses. You can learn a lot about a programming course of what is good and what's bad about it by just reading reviews. So if you think you really have to get a book, do that. But in general, just so you know, I don't generally recommend any book because they're outdated so quickly. And I designed my video courses, and I know a lot of other instructors do the same, to be very complete and not basically needing other information to make them or to help train you in the programming language or framework or whatever it is. So that's it. In general, take a video course in its entirety by itself would be my utmost recommendation. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left-hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here and I'll see you soon.